Hi, I'm Marge Easley with the League of Women Voters. To help with your voting decisions for the primary election, we've invited candidates to talk with us about important issues. Welcome to our video voters guide, and welcome to Jim Bernard, candidate for Clackamas County Commission chair position.
Thank you.
Nice to have you here.
Glad to be here.
I wanted to, in case voters don't know, you're the incumbent in this position, or are an incumbent, but you're running for chair for the first time, is that
correct?
True? And tell voters a little bit about yourself and how you got to be on the commission and your experiences.
Okay, so I own a small business in Milwaukee, which will in May be celebrating 91 years in business. And I always tell people how I got involved in politics is I went to a meeting. At the time, it was a downtown business meeting. I became the president by the second meeting, and from there, became the mayor of Milwaukee in 2001. I was elected shortly after the mayor and city council had been recalled because of light rail. So I served as mayor from 2001 to 2008. Or nine, when in 2008 I was elected to the commission when we went from three to five. I also started the farmers market in Milwaukee. Mm-hmm. I recently bought a little cattle ranch out in Canby, 6 acres, and I raised black Angus cows. Something very different for a city guy. I always say I'm a city guy.
Wow.
And so I've got a lot going on.
It sounds that way.
There's.
Sounds that way. I want to get into some of the issues going on at the county level. And I think the first question is why you're running for chair position. There's been much said in the press about the contentious nature of the commission meetings, and I'd like to know your opinion about that.
Well, first off, in many cases, what we do is not a partisan issue. And so it's quite often that we vote unanimously to move things forward. But occasionally things come up that cause a lot of contention between us. And oftentimes it's a 4-1 vote at that point. But really a lot of it is about the relationship we have with our partners, whether it's at Metro or TriMet, or how we see Clackamas County in the future. We're always looking to be somebody we're not.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's time Clackamas County look at what we want to be, not what Washington County is or what afraid of everything. So one of the reasons I'm running is to rebuild those relationships that have been damaged over the last 3.5 years. And I proved it in Milwaukee with the light rail issue. I don't know if you know it. But it's running now.
Yes,
So I know I can get those people from opposite sides together to resolve Clackamas County's problems.
Okay. One of the problems of Clackamas County is the road maintenance issue, and there will be an advisory vote on the upcoming ballot to ask voters whether they will approve some funding. So tell us a little bit more about that, and do you feel that was the best way to go?
No, I do not feel that was the best way to go. For one thing, we don't really ask them anything. We ask them whether they want us to ask them. Why don't we just ask them? And I'll tell you how we did it in Milwaukee, which I think is very different. We always go out and we try to convince people that we need something, and then they vote no. So what we did in Milwaukee is that we figured out what we needed to do.
Mm-hmm.
We worked with the community to find out what they're willing to spend, and then we enacted it after a series of hearings.
Okay.
Now, if a whole bunch of people came and said, no, this is a terrible idea, we probably wouldn't have done it. But only one person showed. So when we talk about the vehicle registration fee, mm-hmm. for example, and the Selwood Bridge $5 that people said they didn't want to spend, what those people told us is if it's spent in Clackamas County, we'll fund it. So I'm anticipating that they will fund a reasonable vehicle registration fee that could help resolve our $400,000 deficit, which has increased $17,000 a year.
I think it's million you're talking about.
No, it's $400 million.
Okay.
$400 million. Boy, that'd be an easy problem. So $400 million in deficit, which is increased $17 million every year. So we're not going to get the $17 million, but it's a start.
Absolutely. Okay. You mentioned relationships, mm-hmm. and the relationship with Metro has been strained lately. For example, on land use, in particular, the urban reserve issue. Would you like to comment on that?
Sure. About 6 years ago, we worked to draw a map, basically, of what Clackamas County, Multnomah County, Washington County would give, would preserve for up to 50 years. Clackamas County did its work. Washington County did its work. Washington County didn't actually do it right. The court said, start over. Mm-hmm. They made a deal and went to the legislature and resolved it. Well, Clackamas County's problem is much smaller than that. It's basically Stafford.
Right.
But the current chair and other members of the commission have decided they want to start all over. And frankly, get spots south of the Willamette, which is some of the best farmland in the country. It's French Prairie, it's called. And then we need to resolve the Stafford Triangle issue, mm-hmm. which I had an opportunity to resolve or start talking about it when it was just blown up. And Metro said, we're not interested in talking because we're not going to get anywhere under the current board. And constantly in the room, belittling, abusive towards our partners isn't going to get us anywhere.
Okay. I'd like to hear your thoughts also about sustainability.
Okay.
And this is a often thrown about, and it's a word that has kind of various viewpoints far as climate change and that kind of thing. So tell us what your thoughts are about sustainability efforts in Clackamas County.
Well, first thing, I think that the current chair thinks that sustainability is a dirty word, just as multimodal is or transit is. Frankly, build more roads is what I always hear. We cannot build our way with roads out of congestion. We have to provide, alternatives. And so whenever we talk about bike ped paths, it's constantly a battle on we can't spend our money to do that. Well, frankly, the federal government, when you get money from them, requires a certain percentage of it be spent on bike and ped and transit. So we really have to spend our money where we can.
Right.
And unless there's some plan on changing the federal government's point of view of how we spend our money, we need to look at sustainable ways to improve our transportation system.
Okay. Well, one last question, and that is you do have several opponents mm-hmm. In the chair position. Could you tell us why folks should vote for you?
Well, I think that my record says that Jim Bernard can resolve problems. And I talked about Milwaukee. We talked about a tree ordinance, for example, that by the time we got down to the ordinance, it was absolutely useless. Wastewater treatment's a huge issue in Clackamas County. And until we resolve that problem, we're not going to be able to build in the future. So we need to really focus on working with our partners and getting those issues resolved. I can do that. I've proven I can do that, and I can continue to move Clackamas County forward. Forget the past.
Mm-hmm.
Let's move Clackamas County forward and make it the great place we all love.
Thank you so much for being here, Jim.
Thank you. Appreciate it, the opportunity.